Dr. Nick Delgado and Nicholas Delgado. We're talking to you about a serious problem. It's probably more pervasive, more problematic than what we know as the current challenge in the world that we just came out of isolation for. But this is called estrogen dominance. Estrogen is a toxin. It's a toxin to males and females. It's found in plastics. It's found in pesticides and chemicals. And it's found in the consumption of animal product.
Instagram.
Nicholas, when you're trying to accomplish the whole idea of longevity and well-being, although I would do TikTok with that because we got quite a few last time, it's really challenging because people don't see the problem. They don't experience it until they develop problems related to estrogen dominance. Mm-hmm. There's over 40 different conditions that I named in a coming book I have. And although the next book I've created is called Stop Aging Now, we literally had a whole additional book written on this subject of estrogen dominance because we couldn't cover it all in this one extensive book on aging. So the first thing that we look at is we look at what do we need to do from a standpoint of diet and exercise and supplementation? And more importantly, what is it that you're doing from an aging perspective? And does estrogen have anything to do with gaining weight, with having problems associated with toxic fibroids in women, breast lumps, prostate enlargement in men? And the answer is yes. And this is a very, very serious problem. Nicholas, have you ever had your estrogen levels measured? And if so, what have you been doing to monitor? Have you ever had your blood tested for estrogen, your urine tested for estrogen, or saliva, all of which can measure different ways that we detect estrogen?
Yeah, a while ago, yeah. Okay. It's been a while. I got to get it done again.
Mm-hmm. And when you say that, it's been a while. You know, estrogen levels change from month to month and year to year. Mm-hmm. Particularly, listen to this, guys who are optimizing or gals who are increasing their hormonal balance, particularly guys trying to increase testosterone. Testosterone has a nasty habit of converting over into excess estrogen. And so we know this is a problem, and this continues to be a problem. And I'm, you know, kind of wondering and scratching my head why so many people are never alerted by their doctor or health practitioner that they even have an estrogen problem. And I think the answer is kind of evident, and that is that doctors fall short because all they do is test what we call the three standard estrogen levels. And these estrogen levels are ones in which doctors measure is what's called estradiol, estriol, and estrione. So there's the three standard estrogens that most women are tested for. And men sometimes will look at what's called estradiol. But the more harmful of the estrogens is not only estrone, it's what's called 16-alpha-hydroxyestrone and 4-methoxyestrone. The first one, the 16, is associated with what we call the bad estrogens. The 4-methoxyestrone is sometimes associated with colon cancer and other related issues. Dr. Mark Rosenthal once stated that virtually every cancer has a component related to excess estrogen dominance. And since cancer is arguably the second leading cause of death besides cardiovascular disease, stroke, diabetes, and heart attacks, when you have a killer that takes almost more lives besides the number one clogged arteries and so forth, it really needs some attention, and we're going to pay attention to that during this talk. So when you're evaluating a person's estrogen, I want you to recognize that when you do a blood test and you have it sent off and your doctor says, hey, your estrogen level is normal or it's elevated, the truth is when they collect these test tubes and they spin it and send it off to the lab, and you know, we get the measurements and we get the results back, they're really only measuring three, sometimes only one estrogen, when the body has nearly 40 different estrogen metabolites. 40, right. 4-0. And really, I would zero in on at least five of the estrogen metabolites, because when a person has any symptoms that relates to when you gain weight, you hold on to that weight, particularly in the belly area for guys, for women in the hips and thighs. So all of these things, shall I say, become more and more persistent and problematic in a world that's becoming more toxic related to estrogen. Now, if I were to tell you that the average person is exposed to literally millions of molecules of estrogen, let me give you an example how potent and dangerous estrogen is, say, for example, in excess to a man. Let's say a woman is using a cream that has estrogen in it for bioidentical hormone replacement, because mm-hmm. the doctor said, hey, you need estrogen. Mm-hmm. And she's going through menopause and hot flashes, and she's gained some weight, she's moody, she's really going through some challenges. And so the doctor thinks the solution is estrogen, when the more elegant solution we're going to lead up to is a hormone that you would have never expected is better for women to use than estrogen. And I'll remind me about that, because it's really important that women get this clear, and as do men. But this estrogen toxin is something that, when a study was done on young men, 22-year-olds, and they rubbed estrogen cream on their male organ. Yep, their penis. Mm-hmm. For 2 days, none of the men could get an erection or get hard. Estrogen competes with the receptor sites where testosterone belongs, and it actually, along with progesterone, and by the way, sex offenders in jail, they give them progesterone to men to shut down their ability to have sex. True. So these female hormones mm-hmm. are very toxic to men. Now, I don't know about most guys, but, you know, the joy of making love and intimacy were fresh off of Valentine's Day. The mere fact that estrogen can have that damaging effect. And if a man is having, which, by the way, past the age of 40, 50, 60 and on up, the incidents are 40, 50, 60% of men.
Isn't
the
estrogen also damaging towards women too? And not a lot of people talk about that.
Oh, seriously damaging.
Yeah.
And that's why I was, and I'll bridge that topic right now. That's why Dr. Terry Grossman from Colorado and other doctors have pontificated, including Dr. Kathleen Geringer, who's been on our talk show in the past. Mm-hmm. There's a tendency to prefer to use testosterone as the intervening hormone for women who are going through menopause mm-hmm. because some of that testosterone converts over to estrogen, mm-hmm. but not so much, just about the right amount. And the women are going to get a good result without overloading their body with estrogen itself.
Right.
And there's good evidence that this makes sense too. And I've alluded to this before, but because testosterone is measured in nanograms, which is in hundreds, much higher than estrogen, which is measured in picograms, thousands. So even though the number on the lab test might look like, oh, I have more estrogen in the case of a woman, 300 estrogen or whatever, but picograms is a thousandth, much less. Women, if they say have a testosterone of say 30 or 40, it's 100 times more than the estrogen. So, so the testosterone they actually have in their body, the bioactive form, is giving them all the benefit. And then they only need a small amount of estrogen. It's when women and men have what we call estrogen dominance, which by its very name, dominance means there's too much estrogen circulating in their body.
Right.
So what do we do about that? We have to first look at the herbs, the protocols, and the pathways of hormone and estrogen metabolism. So first, let's look at the pathways. This, if my screen share is making it easy for you to see, this is what looks to be a fairly complex, and it's actually far more complex than this. This is just like a little snippet from what we call hormone metabolites and its related components. So if you look over in the category of, let's just start with, say, progesterone. Progesterone goes to 17-hydroxyprogesterone. It goes to androstenedione. Progesterone can turn into DHA. DHA can go to androstenedione, and androstenedione can go into progesterone. And from a derivative of progesterone, the 17-hydroxyprogesterone can turn into cortisol. And cortisol also indirectly can be served by DHEA. So I want you to get the sense that all these hormones are connected and interplay with each other, including testosterone. Testosterone can become androstenedione, or it can come directly from androstenedione into testosterone. I want to hesitate for a moment on this androstenedione. Androstenedione is a very special plant androgen-derived hormone that can only turn into testosterone, and it doesn't turn immediately into estrogen. So I chose that in what we call Scottish pine bark as one of the key androgens in what we call testosterone anabolic MD cream. Mm-hmm. I think sometimes we refer to it as the anabolic tea cream, because some merchant sites have an issue with the word testosterone because it's normally considered a controlled substance. But from the plant derivative and the fact that it's a different analog coming directly from Scottish pine bark, we've been able to get results using this product. This product also has DHEA, and it has pregnenolone, which we're showing DHEA in this pathway. Does that all make sense?
I think it does. I actually use that because I don't drink coffee in the morning.
Right.
So I usually just rub a little bit of that on my wrists and on my neck, and it gives me a big boost for the day. Sometimes I'll even rub a good amount before I work out.
I have a client named Ken Roycroft. He's been using the various versions of this over, let's see, since 2000 and, oh my gosh, maybe 2003, 2005. So nearly a 20-year period. He's never done testosterone pellets, injectable testosterone.
Right.
He's always depended on this product to essentially adjust for or contribute to the balance of four different hormones.
Right.
This product helps to improve the androgen in a different form of testosterone. I'm not saying it's testosterone, even though the word testosterone is in the label.
In some ways, it's a little bit safer than pellets and some other forms of testosterone, is it not?
It is, because with the cream, you can control the amount you use, the frequency.
Mm-hmm.
With a pellet, it's inserted, it's there, and it reaches a peak at least for the first several weeks, and it stays fairly high, and then it gradually comes down. It just depends on what phase of life you're into, but I'll even include gentlemen and women who have taken testosterone pellets to still use this cream. Why?
Right. Mm-hmm.
Because it also has chrysin in it. I'm going to give you a little inside secret. Chrysin, when taken orally, although it works a little bit, we have a little bit of chrysin in Estroblock product, the Estroblock capsules, but as a cream, it's what gives the yellow color to the cream. Mm-hmm. And that chrysin, which is passion flower, it has a nice ability to convert and reduce the estrogens in the body that are wrecking havoc on all of us. Mm-hmm. This cream is like four products in one.
Yeah.
DHEA, the hormone of wellness, very important for brain function and kind of the overall perspective of pheromones. DHEA convert into like that attraction scent that we have for the opposite sex and so forth. And also this product, because it has chrysin, it also has DIM, and absorbed through the skin, very, very potent. I did a study years ago with a Wisconsin laboratory, and the medical director called me up and said, what are you doing? How in the world are you able to convert these urinary hormone metabolites that are normally fairly toxic and clear them? Clearly, you're sending me before after results of people, including yourself, and our levels dramatically changed just using the cream in a month or two. And I told him, I said, there's ingredients in this cream that are absorbed better through the skin than taken orally.
Right.
And those absorb so well, it leads to a potential balance, a desirable balance of our hormone levels.
And this product works so great, you'll notice it almost the first time you try it, right?
I rub it
on anybody, they'll know, they'll come back and they'll be like, wow, I've got a lot of energy.
It's no, particularly in people who have been exposed to more estrogens than others. Mm. And I often tell people, I kid with people, but I say, when I go to health conferences, people are real careful about their diet, their exercise. They're doing okay. They could do with some additional guidance and help, particularly with hormones. Mm. But when I go to conferences where there's entrepreneurs and, you know, guys and gals really focus a lot of their time on whatever they can do to build their business and make money, they're eating, you know, junk food. They're not exercising. They smoke. They drink. I mean, and these people, they really notice the benefits of these products. They notice them because, you know, obviously those people who need the most help often are the ones that don't seek help because they don't normally see doctors, and somehow health is last on their values list. You know, number one is making wealth. And number two is live to eat.
Spending the wealth.
But buying, you know, the very foods and the drinks and things that are, and we know alcohol, for example, beer has a nasty habit of increasing estrogen. They're more so, the hops, I guess it is, more so than any other alcoholic beverage, beer.
Yep.
Very high estrogen levels. Mm-hmm. So if we look back at this pathway, there's an interesting thing with DHT. So testosterone can convert into DHT and androstenediol, then back down to testosterone. So it's a long way before it gets over to estrogen. So DHT is one of the most potent hormones associated with improved erectile function, firmer, stronger body. It does get associated with some degree with being a little more hairy, if you will, right? Certain people have a tendency to grow beards, grow more arm hair, leg hair, and so forth. Mm. So I created a product called DHT Block, and it doesn't exactly block the DHT because we need DHT, but it moves it through its pathways in a safe level so you get the benefit of DHT without having the side effects. And it's like a miracle. I mean, it clears up people's skin. They still get that firm body, that fit profile. But it reduces that likelihood of having that skin problem because deep in the skin, you find people with acne and skin problems, they tend to have more DHT in the skin. Mm-hmm. Whereas DHT is something that isn't really measured that much in the blood or the urine. It's very, very concentrated in the skin in those people who have high DHT. Mm. So I used a product. People knew about Supplemento, and I used an ingredient that I knew would work better, beta-sitosterol, which is about, I don't know, 100 times more potent than Supplemento without, sometimes Supplemento's got some quirky things with it. And whenever I'm putting together an herbal combination, I'm making sure that each of the herbs are going to have a benefit and not cause problems. So even if they do take one pill, two pills is better kind of thought, they're going to still be in a safe range with this product. Mm-hmm. So I've had people get on this product because it was a newer invention after Estroblock and do real well. As I reported in my book, Acne Be Gone for Good. But I also, I'm a fan of people if they want to kind of combine different ingredients in that.
Right. So you'd take this in conjunction with the Estroblock Pro.
Yeah. Yeah. It depends.
And maybe even Live Detox.
Yeah, oh, for sure. Live detox is what we call phase two of estrogen dominance. Mm-hmm. And if you look on the pathway, it shows it right here between androstenedione and testosterone, where there's a tendency to testosterone want to jump over to estrogen, whereas live detox tends to help to enhance the receptor sites, and it allows what's called aromatization. It inhibits the aromatase enzyme. In other words, instead of it converting into more estrogen, it allows it to remain in that testosterone area and give the benefit that testosterone and DHT is well known for. Mm-hmm. So the unique thing is we know that even if you take DHT block, mm-hmm. and estroblock,
right,
some of it is going to slip over into estrogen because estrogen's a nasty molecule. It just wants to wreak havoc on the body.
Right.
So this estroblock, when it gets over here, the estrogen is converted instead of going mostly into the bad 16-alpha-hydroxyestrone, which is potentially carcinogenic, and the 4-methoxyestrone, which has also been shown, as I mentioned earlier, not only to relate to cancer, but colon cancer. Mm-hmm. And then here's the beauty. This jump using the proper delivery of DIM and indole-3-carbinol allows it to convert over to a good protective form of estrogen that can be measured in the urine that we call 2-hydroxyestrone and 2-hydroxyestradiol. Now, here's the exciting thing. Dr. Jonathan Wright, oh no. Oops. Dr. Jonathan Wright showed that when you use the right combination of herbal supplements, you get this nice improvement in what's called 2-methoxyestradiol. Now, not only is 2-methoxyestradiol protective, more importantly, the pharmaceutical companies are racing to figure out how to increase 2-methoxyestradiol. Do you know why?
Mm.
They discovered it's a very potent anti-cancer hormone metabolite.
Really?
It actually combats cancer. Mm. I can't make those claims. I'm just telling you what the medical studies show.
Right.
This is not, mm-hmm. I'm saying, oh, you take this for sure, it's going to reverse cancer. I'm saying that you need to take this kind of product from a protective standpoint. And then, you know, if you look a little further, estriol, which, by the way, women, when they're at their peak of estrogen production as a teenager or a young adult in their 20s or so, mm-hmm. a dominant amount of their estrogen is estriol. That is actually a good hormone. The tragedy is, in our country, the most prevalent type of estrogen in women is not estriol, the good hormone.
Right.
It's estrione.
Estrione, yeah.
Estrione. So that estrione shows up as one of these 2-hydroxy, which is a safer, but the 16-alpha-hydroxyestrone and the 4-hydroxyestrone is very toxic. Mm. And I can assure you, having measured tens of thousands of people over the last, 45 years I've been measuring people, and Jonathan Wright, by the way, who owns a urinary hormone lab called Meridian Lab, and by the way, we use Ryan Consulting Lab. I literally took split samples of urine and sent them to the two different labs, say, which one's more accurate? You know what I discovered?
Hmm.
From the same sample of urine split to two different labs, they had identical numbers. If it said 45 for, say, 2-hydroxyestrone, it was 45 at the other lab.
Right.
It was identical. So the testing reagents are very, very exacting, but not in a 4-point urine. Dutch lab does a 4-point, and we checked it. We weren't happy with its accuracy in terms of what it detected. So that brings me back full circle. That estroblock provides an intercellular cytochromosome, and doctors get thrilled with this talk, and I'm not going to get too deep in it, but the enzymes that inhibit the action of these harmful estrogens. So it shifts the whole estrogen dominant problem to a safer form. And then the live detox stops that conversion to more harmful estrogens. And then if you take something like adrenal DMG, it enhances and supports liver function to improve energy. But here's the real exciting one that we just launched after, I don't know, maybe 5 years I was observing this phenomena. And I called up my lab directors and I said, wow, you see how this ratio of 2-hydroxy to 16. It's a ratio. So most people have a 0.1, a 0.5, 0.2, meaning they have more of the bad estrogen than good. And when they start taking these products, Estroblock, Estroblock Pro,
Live Detox,
DHT block, that estrogen shifts to a good estrogen, the 2-hydroxyestrone. But here's what we didn't anticipate, which made sense once we discovered or understood phase one, phase two, phase three estrogen dominance. And that is too much good estrogen formed.
Right.
After about a year or two. So I wouldn't wait for a year or two. I would intervene at a protective level right from the get-go and use what we call hair skin detox. Now, full disclosure, adrenal DMG, DMG is one of the methyl donors that protects from estrogen dominance. Right. I included an adrenal because I knew the adrenals related to liver function and the immune system and was necessary. And it was really good for autistic kids too, DMG. Literally, Dr. Bernie Rimlin out of San Diego was using DMG with remarkable results for autistic kids. You know, I, for a lifetime, I've been searching for solutions for my son, Lance, who's 30, I guess what he's now, about 36, I guess, 35, 36, January, he just turned. And you know, helping Roman, who, you know, is on the spectrum, but, you know, he's fully functioning now with no issues. But I said, wait a minute, that one methyl donor is good, but there's a different a way to use TMG, which is higher up on the pathway than DMG, and phosphatidylserine, and methylcobalamin, which is a B vitamin methyl donor. So I included all of the best methyl donors in this product. It is crazy what it has, hair, skin, detox.
Right. Awesome.
So we include that package. So people might literally, if they're a little overweight, they'll do Estroblock Pro. They'll stack it with that next level of live detox and hair, skin, detox all together.
Right.
But I tell people.
And the DHT.
Yeah, they'll do DHT too, especially if they have skin problems. Now,
and the adrenal DMG as well.
Well, yeah, because the adrenal, you can't get too much DMG. Let me tell you, it is a, it. There's a whole book written, Wellness with DMG by Roger Kendall, and he goes through all the chemical pathways. I'm a geek when it comes to the biochemistry and the pathways and everything. And this book. The Russian athletes were using DMG to break world records, literally.
Interesting.
Autism, it was shown to improve. It was great for various autoimmune conditions. And the reason is that these methyl donors are involved with glutathione and anti-inflammatory hormone production. It was involved with all, it was, one journal said, DMG and TMG and phosphatidylserine and MSM, which is all in it, are as in second in importance only to drinking water.
Interesting.
It's literally that important. So I've always included some methyl donors in my best product releases. And knowing that, A, you couldn't get too much, and B, when you did get it, your body accepted the various forms of methyl donors at different levels. When you look at the metabolic pathway of all, if I were to spread out a chart, it would cover this whole wall of how all these hormones interplay like an orchestra. So our goal is to help you, the consumer.
Now, hold on. Another question that a lot of our, our customers have is the strong garlicky smell of the adrenal DMG. We actually got a question about it just today from, I forgot who, but you want to touch on that? Because a lot of people ask about that.
I think it was Miguel. I saw him. I saw him clock in today.
Yeah.
So, and by the way, you open the bottle and stronger because, you know, it
smells like garlic.
It's got a scent.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And this is a true story. In my book, Grow Young and Slim, Dr. Ronald Klatz wrote the foreword for the book, Grow Young and Slim. And, you know, he said this was a landmark book and it went into the pathways and no one ever talked about youthful level of hormones. They just said, well, the lab averages for people 40, 50, 60, and that's normal. Normal for an older person, you want that 40, 50, 60% to move their hormones closer to that teenage 20, 25 year old young healthy girl or or you want it like the young, healthy guy. So I'll literally read to you. But this is the funny thing. When you mentioned adrenal DMG,
yeah,
Dr. Klatz, he calls me up all the time and he goes, send me those stinky garlic pills. He doesn't even call it adrenal DMG. He just calls it those stinky garlic pills.
Right.
And here's what he said in quote. He says, grow young and slim. That's this book, right? He says, grow young and slim. Relentlessly zeroes in on the available methods for the reader to become younger, healthier, slimmer, more focused, and more powerful. You could read 50 other books in this field and not walk away with as keen an insight into the new science of anti-aging medicine in Dr. Delgado's newest text. I strongly recommend it. Ronald Klatz, MD, President, American Academy of Anti-Aging Medicine. That's a very strong quote. And by the way, I had other doctors call me up and said, hey, what did you pay Dr. Klatz to give you that quote? I said, I didn't pay him to give me a quote.
No.
He read the book and loved it.
Mm.
And actually, I think he's one of our biggest fans. He loves the fact that, that I do microscopy. And I actually got invited after I submitted an abstract, you know, the official process. Here's the journals. Here's the articles. Mm. And Dr. Klatz and the organization accepted me at that time, prior to the bigger organization, to do live blood microscopy and dry blood microscopy. And I'm just showing a dry sample here. But the point is, my newest book that's about to release, Stop Aging Now, The 7 Codes of Health, I've worked on for more than the last 3 years. And this is probably the only book besides Growing and Slim that I'd tell you, we finally trumped this book. This is the book.
And how long ago did that book come out?
Oh my gosh. This book.
This is one of the original ones.
Oh, this was written here. I'll show you the copyright on it. And I love this book because it's image rich. Take a look at the copyright date here. Here, just take a look. You can read it right there, the copyright date.
Year 2000.
This book still withstood the test of time. I think you can get used copies online on Amazon for about $50 a book, literally.
Yeah.
But 2000, so the new book, 23 years later, Stop Aging Now, takes it to the whole new level.
Mm.
And then the book after, I'm going to release in a few months after, is this estrogen dominance book that's hot on its heels. Because I wrote at the same time, my editor said, no, you got too much here. That was the original criticism, by the way, from Simon & Schuster and all the top public. They said, you got 6 books here. Break it into 6 different books.
Right.
And you know what my answer was at the time? You know, I should have listened to the publishers because they were the ones that determined what gets published or not.
Mm.
But at the time, I told them, I said, listen, I go, if someone's going to truly follow this title, Growing and Slim, they're going to know every one of these chapters, all 20, 21 chapters, what has to happen in order for you to accomplish that goal. Mm. And the new book is also 21 chapters. You know why?
Why?
Well, when I was writing the book, one of the gentlemen that I mentor, who years ago I studied his material, and he was Tony Robbins, he was his favorite business coach.
Mm.
And it's interesting that Eat the Frog First and Make No Excuses, the author is Brian Tracy. And if you look up, there's hundreds of thousands of views on his YouTube channels because he's been doing the audible books of his original books. He has 3 million copies sold in just one of his titles. So in the day and age when selling books, right? I mean, that is just absolutely fabulous, right? But the point is that Brian Tracy stated this. He said, you know what? He goes, call your book The 21 Ways to Stop Aging. And I still kind of like that. That's cool. And then I said, well, how do I make it 21 ways? He said, do 21 chapters. I said, okay, I did 21 chapters. That's where that came from. But right now we kind of settled it on just making it simple, you know, Stop Aging Now.
Right.
Because it really gets down to 7 key codes of health.
Right. Okay.
I just want to go back in history more than 4,000 years ago. And it's called the genius of China. But they knew when older men were able to acquire the urine from young 20-year-olds and turn it into like a urine paste and rub it into their skin. And they took the young females, 20 years old, and rubbed it into the old 70, 80, 90-year-old women. Mm-hmm. There's over 100 hormones in urine, according to Dr. Jonathan Wright. And they truly were onto something that does reverse aging. So when you're studying hormone metabolism and urine metabolism, every cancer patient that comes to me and wants coaching, mentoring, I'm not, again, interfering with their medical treatments, but I turn them to the direction of, hey, first you have to shut off the exposure to estrogens if you're going to challenge this serious problem we call cancer. Second, you've got to learn how to convert all these harmful estrogens out of the body. And third, you got to know what herbs have the right action. And guess what? Apricot seed, the use of passion flower, the use of asparagus and ginger, all these things are in live detox.
Yep.
And they've been used for centuries. Cranberry, pomegranate, all these things.
Right.
And I looked at it and I said, how can I improve upon a non-toxic method to clear the body? And I'm going to bank on the fact that only 5% of people are going to change their diet. The truth is 97% of people fail because they don't change their diet.
Right.
But when they take these herbs, they start noticing, hey, I'm improving. And then they come on these mentorship coaching classes. And real shortly, we're going to offer diet ID, which goes into people take tests and they check how close they are to their goal of a Mediterranean diet. Hopefully they'll do a plant-based oil-free diet compared to, you know, various other kind of healthy, if you will, pescatarian diets that are at least healthier than the American diet, right? Not wacko like carnivore or keto. Although there is an animal-based, a plant-based keto that's whole nuts, seeds, avocados, olives, not the separated oils. And there's good evidence that that's okay. If you're going to do keto, only do it that way.
Right.
The point is, who's done all this work for the last 45 years? I've been working on it since I was when I was a teenager. I was fascinated by this whole subject of cancer. And then I ran into my own problem with being overweight, skin problems, and challenged with fatigue. And then later I got some scares with cancer markers. And I looked at all this thing and I said, it's going to take ultimately what I realized, much like drday.com, D-R-D-A-Y, Dr. Lorraine Day, she talks about how she herself has become cancer-free. Now she's 84 years old. Following what she calls the 10 steps, I honed in on 7 steps. She kind of ignores the hormone component. It's just not her strength.
Right.
But she's incredibly spot on when it comes to juicing. You're big on blending, exercise, getting away from toxic people. That's one we always have to work on.
Right.
and dealing with the power of the mind and advanced therapeutics, stem cells, hyperbaric oxygen. But you like CVAC. We're going to talk about some of these things in this class, but before I transition from these slides, here you go, live detox, wasabi root, turmeric root, ginger root, astragalus, pomegranate seed, asparagus. But do you know that Amazon didn't let us sell this product with the apricot seed in it because they didn't like it that the clinical study showed, and the original, there was a big trial in the Senate and they ruled in the favor of the apricot seed, and they didn't, you know, there was a whole like trial about it. But so these things have been, you know, kind of formulated and created for good reason. And then our number one seller, still bar none, Estroblock Pro, triple strength. It's got the DIM, the indole 3 carbonyl. So it's got the cruciferous vegetable extracts at work. It's got wasabi. It's just, it's got the right delivery system. I mean, I don't I think there's tens of thousands of kids who have cleared up their skin.
Right.
And little did they know, I believe it's helping them prevent risk of cancer too.
We didn't even know about this when we first came out with it. We kind of stumbled upon it that it helps fix acne.
Yeah.
And that's what made it such a huge seller to everybody.
Right, right. So when you look at, you know, all of these components, you know, it all gets back to, if you're going to maximize testosterone, you're going to have to understand how estrogen and how to manipulate and deal with it. So here's another thing that I got real excited about. And I released this only this last year. And I entered in what they call the DIM wars. I had what was called DIM 259, right? And then someone came out with DIM 400 and DIM whatever, 300. And I'm like, you guys don't understand that just because they have, quote, a higher number, it doesn't mean that it's getting absorbed.
Right.
Because they have no clue. There's only one other guy. I'll give you abbreviations, MZ, that understands this delivery system.
Mm.
Only one. The rest of them are using like pepper called Bioprin to deliver. That is so left field. It's so not going to work.
Right.
And all you got to do is compare their knockoff products to what we're doing. So I did DIM 855, but I one-upped everyone. I said, wait a minute. What would I take that would be even beyond or in conjunction with Estroblock Pro, Live Detox, DHT Block.
That helps absorb everything.
And Hair Skin Detox. Mm-hmm. Oh, no, all those absorb.
Right.
They all have the absorption.
Well, what helps with this one to absorb versus other DIM products?
Okay. First, we have the only known approved way of absorption and integration at the cellular level of the key ingredients. But here's the big thing about this product.
Mm.
There was all kinds of great new information about sulforaphane, broccoli sprouts, cognition, protection from cardiovascular disease, and most importantly, cancer.
Mm.
And I included the highest amount of broccoli sprouts of anything on the market. There is no other product that matches.
Right.
So what I did was I stacked it in a safe amount of DIM, and I'm not going to disclose how much, because I'm not going to enter that DIM war, because that's not the truth. The truth, full disclosure, is how much gets in and what active ingredients are within it to allow the body to go through phase one, phase two, phase three, detoxifying, which is the title of this topic, male and female toxic estrogens, detoxify them. What is the solution?
Right.
And I'm telling you now, I personally take this product along with the other products. My levels have bounced out so well over the years. I'm obviously the longest user of this product of anyone, going back early 2000. I literally was the first to create a cream that had DIM in it at that time. And it was already a Estroblock that came out and was patented by 2003 by me.
Mm-hmm.
So when you look at, I'll correct myself, registered trademark, when you look at it, which by the way, I don't have to release my formula. It's always proprietary. Anyone asked me, I said, I have to shoot you if I were to tell you. I can't let you live and know my formula. It's like Coca-Cola has their formula divided in two safes and no one knows the real formula. No one knows this real formula except me. And the truth is that this product has been helping people by itself or in conjunction with the whole spectrum.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the full story. That's full disclosure. If that makes sense, I want you to have the confidence to know, ladies and gentlemen, that when you're wanting the ultimate approach to enhance libido, remember how I said earlier, Nicholas, that they did experiments and they took young men,
right,
intimately active, and all they had to do was rub estrogen cream on their male organ, and not one could get, if you will, hard for 2 or 3 days. And some women use estrogen creams intervaginally. Mm. And little do they know, or maybe they do it knowingly, if they don't want to have activity. And I mentioned, what do they say in prisons? What do they use to blunt sex offenders? What hormone do they use?
Estrogen.
No, progesterone.
Oh, okay.
So there's this big movement I noticed for a long time where guys were rubbing on progesterone on their body. I go, oh, you, dude, you're messing with the wrong hormone. And progesterone, it is a, it's somewhat of a, it can be categorized as an estrogen inhibitor, but you need a little bit of estrogen to involve or enjoy or to approach and accomplish ideal results. So that being said, what do you need to do to accomplish the results? And I'm telling you right here and now that your number one goal should be understanding estrogen management. But I'm going to go a step further and say, before you understand estrogen dominance, you need to appreciate peptides. But here's the first hormone that everyone should deal with before we get to the peptides. And what do you think that is? Bar none and without exception, the very first product everyone should learn to use.
Adrenal DMG.
Adrenal DMG, and why is this so, so important? Adrenal DMG is important because cortisol and the adrenal function is why the entire world was shut down. And I know you might think, come on, Dr. Nick, you're exaggerating this whole conversation about the use of adrenal function that was first coined by a famous doctor during the 1950s when the worst flu outbreak had ever occurred, killing more, way more people than the current end of the pandemic, if we call it end. And I described this in this book, and it turned out it was adrenal function that was the solution. And that's why when President Trump was in Walter Reed, the first thing they gave him, you know what it was? When he had, quote, COVID, and he was, you know, they were worried about him, they gave him dexamethasone, which is an adrenal, very potent, 50 times more potent than cortisol. This is the book that all hormone experts refer to, Safe Uses of Cortisol. And the original book was called Safe Uses of Cortisone, but it got confused with hydrocortisone. And people are wasting away. There's anabolic and catabolic effects in the body. And if they don't understand peptides and the absorption of hormones and growth hormone and DHA, if they jump right first to DHA, testosterone, and human growth hormone, their adrenals are going to be overwhelmed and they're going to get sick. They're going to get colds and flus. They're going to have downtime. They're just really going to kind of drop in function. So if you first support the adrenals, that's why I said do this first. And if a cold or flu comes on or COVID or whatever it is, and I shouldn't be using that word at all because of all the, I won't get into the issues with, you know, what they say about words. I made it very clear in my book, Blood Doesn't Lie, that the truth is that all of this begins with your adrenal function, and no one, whenever they're given sufficient cortisol, within 48 hours, William Kenley Jeffries gave people who were on death's door with a deadly flu at that time in the 1950s. And you know what they gave them? High dosages of hydrocortisone, a.k.a. cortisol, a.k.a. adrenal DMG, which is the glandular that supports the release of cortisol. And people say, well, wait a minute. That's a quite a leap to say that supporting adrenals produces more cortisol. I'm living proof.
Anytime I start feeling like I'm getting sick, or if I'm already sick, I take a bunch of adrenal DMG, as you know, about five a day.
It's a freaking lifesaver. I ran out. Hey, smell the stinky pills here, right?
Yep, garlic, just like garlic.
Garlic.
I like garlic, so it doesn't bother me.
But see, this is one of 20 ingredients in here.
Yeah,
this crazy product. I stacked it. I said, look, if I'm going to put something out there that purportedly improves the immune system, fights colds and flus, fights fatigue, fights addictions, all of these things that I'm suggesting based on all the research.
Mm.
I could have jumped ahead and given you a prescription called cortisol, hydrocortisone.
Mm.
The synthetic high dose ones that linger in the body too long are called like prednisone and dexamethasone. Those are corticosteroids. Mm. We didn't want to mess with those because corticosteroids got a bad name because they're so harsh. They're too strong on the body.
Right.
And people would get the reverse effect. They initially get this wonderful result. And then like, oh my God, my arthritis is gone. Oh my God, my fatigue is gone. Oh, I feel great. And then all of a sudden they'd get Dowager hope. They'd start gaining weight. They start having problems from too much.
Mm.
Because even 5 milligrams of prednisone or corticosteroid, you know, when they shoot the athletes in the knee with corticosteroids.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
When they have an injury. Should only do one injection, but they do multiple injections, and they are, yeah, their body's so overwhelmed that there's a point where their body just goes the opposite and just really falls apart.
Hmm.
So I looked at it and I said, wait a minute. I want the benefits without causing people to fall apart. And I said, I'm going to invent, and I did. And this Brad Axelrod, we have a quote from him on video, and he goes, when Dr. Nick told me about this and I was suffering from chronic fatigue because I drink coffee and I'm up late and I'm pushing the envelope and I'm a biohacker.
Right.
And when he tried this product, you know what he said? He said, without exception, he said, this product, in exact quote, saved my life. He's now in Mexico right now. He travels a lot.
Mm.
And he, I will tell you, if I couldn't take any other product here, I wouldn't even hesitate. It'd be adrenal DMG. Oh, yeah.
Right.
Because it's everything, your immune system, your energy. And I found out that when I started taking hydrocortisone, and this was recommended by a world-class doctor, Dr. Ter Hertog. Anyone who knows, he's got a heavy accent. He's from Belgium. And he describes all of these hormone problems. And there's all this pictorial. This book's like a $500 book. And I have other textbooks by him. And I've recorded all of his material. He gave me permission in Chicago, and I recorded everything. Mm. I produced the tapes for his university because he's got a medical university.
Mm-hmm.
This guy is a genius when it comes to hormones. After Shelley, your mom, died, I turned to him. I said, you're the thyroid expert in the world because your dad, before endocrinology, had discovered Hertog syndrome, named after him, and thinning of the eyebrows and hyperthyroidism and low thyroid, and they knew how to treat it with Armour, a glandular of thyroid.
Wow.
And then they got together with Dr. David Brownstein and understood iodine. That's why I created...
Red iodine. It's over here.
Where?
Yeah. I have to go use the restroom.
Yeah. I created... Duck under. Big boy. I created rad iodine because the body needs thyroid support. So tie that in with thyroid cytotropin, and you're going to get a great result because people who have adrenal problems often have thyroid problems. So when you're looking at an elegant solution, that elegant solution needs to be one in which you lean into each of the bioidentical hormones, understand the history of why we have gone beyond functional medicine. Functional medicine is a whole branch, just like lifestyle medicine, anti-aging medicine, energy medicine. I studied with all the greats in these areas. And it's interesting that Dr. Hertog himself refers to safe uses of cortisol by William McKinley Jeffries. And also, my book goes into great detail the discovery of these various aspects of hormone replacement and what it takes to live a longer, better quality life. I'm gonna open it up to some questions here. I've kind of done a little bit of a deep dive, and the importance of getting your hormones measured by urine, blood, and saliva. I space them out about four weeks to 2 months apart, because as you're following these programs, we kind of want to see where your levels are going, what's working for you. We can do blood spot, or we can send you to a local lab with Access Lab. And you just look it up on our website, you pay for the test, and it gives you, you just put in your zip code, and it shows you what's close to you. But if I don't have any questions at this moment, I'm going to check the chat right now to see. We also use peptides. human growth hormone, one of the ultimate peptides. So let's see if anyone has any questions. Okay, so can we take adrenal DMG at night? And the answer is yes. There's no stimulants in adrenal DMG. There's no, there's no caffeine. It's got DMG, dimethylglycine, the methyl donor. So this product works really well in helping to support healthy adrenals. And this is the inside word. You can't overdo adrenal DMG. It will tell you that take three capsules, and there's 180 capsules in here, divide three into 180, right? So you've got 90 capsules. So even if you took six a day, this is a month supply. There are times when I feel like something's coming on and I got to deal with it. I won't take six. I'll take another three at night. Why? Miguel, because in the morning, what you took at night is working in your system, and you wake up, and usually, you know, at bedtime, when your adrenals are at their lowest, that's when you have the worst symptoms of colds and flus and fatigue, and maybe it's interfering with your sleep. So I'm a big fan of first, based on Access Lab, knowing particularly saliva levels morning, midday, afternoon, because saliva is one of the best ways to monitor cortisol changes. If you have that drop off in the afternoon, then that's when you should be taking adrenal DMG, right? So yes, we can take adrenal DMG at night, and yes, it is effective. And then Doc Steve says, hey, the best dose and place to apply testosterone cream. Well, I use both the Estroblock cream and the testosterone cream, anabolic MD. Why? Because you're really now balancing out five hormones. Now, the Estroblock, you'll look it up, does have a touch of progesterone. Remember, I'm not a big fan of a lot of progesterone on men. Women can handle progesterone better than men. But I use a very small dose. Instead of like 500 milligrams that a lot of progesterone creams have, it's like 10 milligrams. Very safe amount. So even if you use a little too much of this cream, it's not going to interfere with erectile function or cause other issues, but it's going to give you the benefits of progesterone. So I like to take the cream, and I like to apply it like right behind the neck. There's a lot of blood vessels right behind the ears and the neck, like right there. And then it's got a nice scent too. And all, with the wind lately and the, you know, dry, I rub it in the dry areas, wherever there's dry areas, where there's this thinnest skin. Oops, too close there. The thinnest part of the skin, and it absorbs really nicely. I don't use it in the fatty tissue areas. I use it in the thinner areas. Now, I will say the anabolic MD cream has an ingredient that's designed to deal with cellulite. So usually I use this cream in the thin areas, but I openly, full disclosure, encourage men and women to use the cream on their cellulite areas. Men don't usually have cellulite, women do. And that's a whole discussion that I covered in a video recently. So that being said, and the next question, can teenagers take Estroblock? It's great. It's fantastic for teenagers. And when I wrote the book, Acne Be Gone for Good, I would say the largest users of Estroblock Pro, Estroblock Regular, DHT Block, and a certain degree Live Detox is teenagers. We have rather dramatic results. If you look here, camera two, rather remarkable results before after pictures in young individuals who have been plagued with acne and skin problems. And that's why it's used so prolifically after the influencers like Tracy Love Vitamin and the Live Detox lady wrote about it. These people, you know, had their success stories using our product. We didn't pay them anything. Fran Kerr and Tracy of Love Vitamin site has gotten remarkable results in helping kids, teenagers. So it's very safe. Plus, I believe if teenagers, I don't know, follow an unhealthy diet. And what teenager do you know that follows a healthy diet is kind of rare, right? All these things are important. Now, Doc Steve made a good comment. No, that was ivermectin that Joe Rogan was talking about. It wasn't cortisol or hydrocortisone. The big podcasters have no clue. And guess who confirmed that my discussion about the solution for flu and the whole isolation, none other than Dr. Terry Hertog, world expert, agrees with me that the cortisol, hydrocortisone, and so forth is the front line of defense to protect people with these cortisol issues and related to flu, fatigue, and also addictions. So knowing that all of these things are going on, the best use of hormonal balance begins with this whole kind of story. And I'm going to paraphrase the story. The story being that health, happiness, and longevity is predicted by how many times you are consistent with this whole program. And Aaron's asking, how many capsules of adrenal DMG would you recommend to take in a day for a cold or flu prevention? That's a great question. And I'm going to answer it to tell you that the incredible Safe Uses of Cortisol book recommended using 20 milligrams times 4 per day of cortisol, which there's been times I've had my clients or even myself, I'll get the prescription item cortisol and take it along with adrenal DMG. And at the peak of problems, every 4 hours, I will take 4 capsules. So that's quite a bit. You say, well, but 16 capsules is going to fully support the immune system at every level. And we're coming out with a Spanish label. We're going to go through clinical tests to verify because the Mexican laws, they want tests clinically tested. So it's about a year process, but we're starting that process soon. And I'm here to tell you that the prevention of colds or flus, guess what natural energy medicine suggestion you do in conjunction with adrenal DMG, and besides the obvious of hydration, eating more healthy plant-based foods, you know, get very clear about what you need to do to live a longer, better quality life. The sun, my gosh, the sun is one of the quickest ways. Not my son who was just on the show, but sunlight. Wherever you can get out, even on a dim day, but the sun helps produce what? Natural cortisol. That's right. The sun. Oh, my gosh. Indoor light, even in a studio like this, there's, I don't know, barely 5,000 lux of energy. Outdoors in the sun, there's 50,000 lux of energy. L-U-X, lux. Look it up. So the sun is huge for the protection of the body. The sun is critical when combined with adrenal DMG. Now, ivermectin, it's another discussion. There's a lot of controversy about it. I don't think there's any harm in taking an anti-parasitic, especially some of us get exposed to parasites. Under live blood analysis, I mean, full disclosure, this is dry blood, but you see certain microbes and things in the blood and the body. And I want you to know that these are things that I've been actively scientifically researching and searching for. Now, it came up recently. Someone said, well, hair, skin, nail, what product is all vegan? And that's called Neuro Inspire, also known as Mental Focus in the blue label. Neuro Inspire, Mental Focus, it has the methyl donors and it's completely plant-based vegan. So I'd say a majority of our products are plant-based vegan. Only about three of them, full disclosure, have, I don't know, you know, whether it be glandulars. And gosh, I'd be hard pressed to say that glandulars are a problem, because they've been clinically evaluated to support thyroid, adrenal function, spleen, so thymus gland, adrenal gland, and thyroid gland. Those are important. If you choose not to use those, it can be synthesized in a laboratory without the animal byproduct and still get the bioidentical equivalent. But I'm also kind of a big fan of, the whole support system of life and longevity. Lately, I've had friends bring me a family member who's struggling, say, with cancer. And so I'm always looking, you know, what can we do to approach a good, healthy profile? And Jason's there mentioning, I like Neuro Inspire. It's good stuff. Do you still make the Amore V? That one is amazing. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. We got a shipment of Amore V in. It's probably 10 times more potent than anything on the market. I mean, those of you guys who have tried it. But, you know, full disclosure, it's gone up in price almost 10 times. I don't know what to tell you. I wish I could control that, the production of raw ingredients and access and stuff. But we've got it down to where you can get it like one pill for $15. Some people buy three pills, so that's like $45. Those three pills, you know, they'll stay in your system a good couple days. So, oh yeah, Neuro Inspire. But I like to, with Amore, now that you bring it up, which is one of our best-selling products, I like to combine it with the peptide called Grow Young. You spray in your mouth at night and at bedtime. And I like to include it with Dr. Delgado's, testosterone booster. That's this one. With these capsules, they release more of the free bioavailable testosterone. Nothing short of a miracle. And the sacral wedgie here, I'm going to take it out of its box. Here, it's got a little seal here. So the point is, this little device raises your pelvic floor. And it's going to be really, really simple design. The pink is for the women. Here we go, sacral wedgie here. Okay, so it literally looks like this. Now, you lay on it, like it goes right under your sacrum, like, right? Like you lay on it right under your sacrum, right at the buttocks line, right? And it raises up that sacrum. Now, could you match this and create something like it? Well, football coaches used to just kind of put their hand and bunch it together to hold the sacrum up for 20, 30 minutes, and the player, the spasms in their low back would go away. And that was a solution. But you're not going to sit there and want to, and I've tried to bunch up like a towel. It doesn't work very good. This thing lets it just settle right into your sacrum, and you lay on it for about 20 minutes. It is the most amazing natural reliever of back discomfort that I've ever come across. Go ahead and try this device. I think it lists on our website for $49. I think they're giving a few specials to practitioners out there. But check this out. I just wanted to share with you that a simple device like this works great. And also my shoulder sphere, to reduce the risk of needing shoulder surgery and that type of thing. There, in talking to Dr. Marianne Hanani, who just graduated with her certification course, she agrees. I tend to combine PT-141 with Semirelin GHR2, GHR6. I mean, one is a growth factor type thing. The other one's more for, you know, erotic enhancement. I haven't seen any downside. I found that they work perfectly. And ever since she told me that, I'll tend to do a second injection with, it's a tiny little insulin needle, you know, 31 gauge. So I'll prepare, like I'll put BP 157 together with maybe beta thymosin, you know, because they're both like immune enhancer type things. So I can sometimes combine like and like. And other times I'll use like an IGF extender. And I've combined that at times with Semerel and GHR2 and with GHR6, because that comes already combined. So there are peptide companies that already pre-combine peptides. So I wouldn't blanketly say you can't combine, you know, any peptide. I find you can. But just think about it. If GHR2 and GHR6 is a short chain molecule of growth hormone, just like you can get a GH, say, 124, but the whole GH molecule is 191 amino acid chain. If you combine a 6 and a 12 theoretically with say a 141, you're going to start combining those chains and it's going to maybe reduce the effectiveness. It's not going to harm you, but it's going to reduce the effectiveness. So I'm okay with doing, you know, two different injections, three different injections. I tend to cycle them. I'll use a couple different hormones together 3-4 days in a row, particularly, you know, when I'm with my girlfriend and stuff. And other times I'll just want maybe the immune enhancing BP-157 and alpha thymosin. So I'm good about rotating. And I find with my oral Grow Young, which is regular $300 peptide right now on special for, I think it's $159. It typically sells for, you know, like in the $200 range, but $159 is a really good deal. So I spray that at bedtime and in the morning. I notice when I inject my peptides and I spray this at night, I do sleep deeper. No doubt about it. Much deeper quality of sleep. And that deep quality sleep is so important for rejuvenating your whole body and all of your hormones. Well, this is Dr. Nick Delgado. And the great news this week, visit 7pillarscoaching.com. Thanks, everyone. Be well, be strong. I'm going to just tune out and thanking you for being such fun.